is, I have a few things to say. For one, I cannot do, what is that, finger fluttering? I'm so bad at it. Anyway, thank you for all the support. That means, comments, just, someone going in the comments and putting great job or nice video. There are many of you who do that. It's so, does that make sense? It's so appreciated. But really though, I do really appreciate that. So any comment you leave, thank you. We're closing in on 300, not really, but you know, we're at like, we're nearing 270. I don't know what we're at as the time I upload this, because I've actually been making a lot of videos due to the fact that I've been making a lot of role plays, because with the green screen, my capabilities are a little higher than they were before. So the next thing I wanted to say was the Super Bowl. I threw that Super Bowl one really quick. I actually made it during halftime, but it took way too long to export, so I didn't get it uploaded during halftime. And then even after the export, I had to upload it. So the Super Bowl was super, super boring. I actually didn't even watch the first half, and I came down near the end, and it was still 3-3. And then, of course, the Patriots took the lead. And then, I'm not going to lie, I was rooting for the Rams. But, and I was hoping for a Hail Mary pass, but he didn't even get the punt. So, you know. But, not going to lie, it was a pretty boring game. I wasn't fully focused on the halftime show because I was uploading this video, so I had to do that. But even the halftime show seemed like, you know. But yeah. So also one last thing: why am I wearing a stupid red orange shirt? Or at least it looks stupid on me. That's super short and tight. Well, that's because I realized why the green screen was really. You might have noticed it looked like a pixely type thing, and it's because if it even get my lighting's bad, so if it even gets the hint of blue or black, it will mistake it as green. So I just realized this last night because I was putting on like a blue shirt, and I'm like, blue, green, like come on. But since my lighting was not good, I didn't have the sun like I do now and stuff, it just wasn't working, and it didn't even like, I guess it did make me transparent. So I got the farthest thing I possibly could in my drawer from green, which was this, and it works. I look stupid, and it's a really short shirt I probably wore when I was like 12 years old, but regardless, that's what we're gonna have to, that's what we're dealing with. So thank you so much for listening to my ramble. You might have skipped it, don't really care, because you did come here for a guided meditation. So with that said, as you can see, we're on a nice beach. Very nice beach, very nice beach, very, very nice beach. So, what I want you to do is take a deep breath, okay? Close your eyes, take a deep breath. Because my nose is still running. My cold ended like a long time ago, and I got it like 4 weeks ago, but deep breaths, just, it really does help to clear the mind, because if you're really focusing on how it feels, how the air building up in your lungs, if you really focus on how that feels, you're taking your attention away from your thoughts, and that's so important, because a lot of our thoughts are negative. It's just not good. Even if it's just occasionally thinking about that one thing that happened earlier in the morning, if you're thinking, I wish it didn't happen, I feel stupid, or I feel this, or I feel that, even just doing that once leads to you kind of doing that over and over again, and it's just just not good thinking of these negative things puts you in a negative mood. So we have to clear that mind. So deep breaths, really focus on the breath, because some people do deep breaths while they're thinking of things and they're just like, this is not working at all. Like, what why can't I do it? And it's just that you're not focusing on the breath. You can't just breathe and all your thoughts are gonna stop because you're breathing all the time. Of course, that's unconsciously, but still, you have to yeah, just send a helicopter. That's fine. Basically, if you look at the bigger picture, I look at these problems I have all the time, and I really am pretty upset. But when I see what's on the news headlines, or I see this article or that article, I'm just like, why am I upset about this? You know, it's just so stupid. So again, that's not the case for all of us. Some of us really are going through a rough patch or a loss, or they're just feeling upset or stressed. It happens, okay? Maybe it's all the time. I don't know your situation, but all I'm saying is, for those of you out there who are fortunate enough to have those little problems, because these people out here who are really suffering, they wish they had your problems. You're upset, you're mad, and you're upset, and they wish that they had your problems because they have much bigger issues. So just realize, think of some of those problems that maybe really aren't that big of a deal. Okay, so now that we've acknowledged that some of our problems really aren't that bad, maybe some of them are, we just need to let that go, because those are just gonna come back and they're gonna be like, oh yeah, you forgot to be sad. We don't need that right now. Let's ignore those thoughts, okay? Ignore those thoughts. Anyway, let's get back to the guided meditation. So we've taken our deep breaths, our mind's cleared. Now we might not be in a positive state, but we're definitely not in a negative one, at least I would hope. So take those deep breaths, keep going if you have to just really relax you. And if you at any point drift off, the moment you notice that you've drifted off, just bring yourself right back and keep up with that breathing, because it really gives us, because if I say to you, focus on that wall, now a wall is pretty boring, am I right? Staring at a wall, it's pretty boring. So what you're going to do is you're immediately going to start, at least in a little bit, start thinking about stuff, and then realize, oh, I'm supposed to be staring at the wall, which you were just thinking. But when you're breathing, when you're feeling that, you're really putting your attention and focus on it, okay? So go back to that breathing every once in a while. Now, with that said, let's travel. Now, I'm on a beach. This is my happy place right here, okay? But what we want to do is go to your happy place, okay? Wherever that may be. I don't care if it's in Disney World, or maybe it is a beach. Maybe it's your grandparents' house. Maybe it's your house. Maybe it's just a vacation you went on. I don't care where it's at, just go to the place that you feel your most happiest, at your happiest point. So, close your eyes, deep breaths, and travel to that place. Now, if you want to be alone, that's fine. If you want to be with the family members, your friends, whoever you want, okay? that's fine. Okay. Now just feel the happiness, okay? Just feel that happiness inside. So, you've traveled to your dream place, your happiest, your happy place, and you're there with whomever you want. So, you're there, wherever you're at, with friends, family. Okay. You're having a great time. You feel so happy whatever you're doing. It could be reading, you could be in a pool with your friends, does not matter. It can be summer, winter, you could be sledding, don't care. So you're just having a good time. You're enjoying yourself. So feel that happiness, that joy, because you're free, you're with your friends, you're doing what you want, where you want, when you want. Okay. So now that's a bit more of a positive state that you're in now due to feeling that. So what we're gonna do is I think I did this last time where I said I don't wanna pick a spot. I'd have you pick, but it's kind of hard to relax if your dream spot's like a super loud party. So what we're gonna do is, I'm not gonna move the camera, whoops, but we're gonna go to a beach. So picture that in your mind. Picture a beach in your mind. So now you're in a bit of a more positive state. You're on the beach knowing that you're going to go back to your friends really soon. You're going to go back to your family soon, wherever you want. So anyway, you're on that beach and the waves are just rolling in. You can hear the waves just rolling in. And you're laying on this beach. Laying down on the nice warm sand. It's not cold out, it's definitely not cold out, but it's not hot either. So the weather's nice, the sun is shining on you, beautiful trees, nice warm sand, beautiful ocean, clear water. You can see a lot of the sea life, a lot of the marine life, amazing, amazing stuff. So you're sitting there and you're just at a sense of complete peace, of bliss. Now, you might not be able to feel this if you don't really know what bliss is like. What do I mean by bliss? So, well, at least, I guess, I don't know if bliss is that word, but you're just, I guess, at peace, and you're just present, you know? Like, if you've ever had any time where you've just really, like, if you listen to music and you just felt the music and you were just there in the present, and just, like, a sigh of relief, but it's like a sigh of happiness, you know? Like, happiness, relief, I don't know. But, you just ever have that happiness sigh where you're like, everything's gonna be okay. So, and not only is it when you're just, like, fully present, but you also forget about the worries. And here's the other thing, you don't need anything. See, all the time, whether we realize it or not, a lot of the time we wish we had something. If I'm in school, I wish I was at home. If I didn't go to school, and I was working or something, if I had a job, let's say, I wish I had this job. I'm glad I have this job, but I wish I had this job. Or, I wish I could reach 1,000 subscribers, like, by tomorrow or something. Or, I wish I was a successful YouTuber right now. Or, I wish I had this higher-paying job, that higher-paying job. I wish I had a higher education, whatever it is. So we always wish we had things. We always want things. But when you're in that peace and that bliss, you are fine where you're at. And that is a magical moment. Because if you're okay with where you're at, that's when you've reached peace and bliss. Let me tell you something, some wise words of wisdom here that I'm going to drop on you right here. Maybe I've said this. It's just crazy that we live for tomorrow. Always, we live for a better tomorrow. You do all the hard work now so you can have a better job tomorrow or a higher paying job tomorrow. And you're always working for tomorrow. But if we're always working for tomorrow, when are we going to enjoy it? See, the reason we work for tomorrow is to enjoy it, but you can never enjoy tomorrow. Because tomorrow never comes. Tomorrow is today. Then tomorrow, guess what? Today, tomorrow, today. So, it's just crazy because if I reach 1,000 subscribers, then I'm working every day to reach 1,000 subscribers, and then I keep going. I push the limit once I reach 10K, 100, then a million, then 10 million, then I beat PewDiePie and T-Series all at once and get 100 million, okay? So we're always working for a better tomorrow, but if we never enjoy it, what is the point? So, I want to see how I can explain that more in depth because it really is a deep thing that does need to be talked about in more depth. Gotta gather my thoughts. So, you can look at a successful person, most successful person in the world, and he had it all okay. He has it all, he or she, whoever, it can be anyone, anyone you want, you can make the person up, whatever, can have everything that you want, that he or she wanted, but at the end of his life, you say, you did it all, you are just the luckiest person I've ever known, and he says, he or she, I didn't even get to enjoy what I got, because he pushed himself, and that is good. Perseverance is good, but if you never stop to enjoy it, because let's say he wanted to get this car, right? He got this car, but not once did he go, oh, I can't believe after all this time I wanted this car. He just went straight to the next one, straight to the next goal. I want a Lamborghini now. Then when he got a pretty nice house, he went straight for the mansion, straight for the better job to lead to the mansion. And you say you had a mansion, you had tons of cars. Like, how did you not? Because he was working, he was busy going to the next thing. He never got to enjoy it. See, what is the point of getting all that if we can't enjoy it? Because there is none. Because then he or she will say, well, what was the point? Because I literally got all of it. And then when you're out of time, you say, I got all of it, but I never got to use it or appreciate it or enjoy it. So that's what I'm trying to say there. Pretty deep stuff if you can get a grasp on it. But it's just we have to enjoy it because, I mean, for starters, that's the reason we wanted it. The reason we wanted the car was to feel fulfilled and happy. That's why we wanted the house, etc. So, that's that. So really, just, if you're at that point where you can just really enjoy right now, that's awesome. If you can let go of all the issues, all the problems, and say, I don't need anything anymore, I'm right where I want to be, that's awesome. Because if you never stop to appreciate it, what is the point? Again, what is the point? Because if you're always working for tomorrow, you know, you will never actually be able to experience the things you earned. I don't know where I was going with that. I was kind of restating it, but trying to reword it to make it sound a little better. But anyway, so really, just, you're on that beach and you're just enjoying. just, you're there, you're present, and you don't need anything. You're not saying, oh, I wish I was here, or I wish I had a better job, or I wish I had that, because you're free, you're on a beach, you're relaxed, you have no priorities, you can do what you want, and you're just on that beach, perfect weather, perfect ocean, perfect sand, perfect trees, and it's just amazing. It is absolutely amazing. You're just there and you're relaxed. There's nothing to worry about. There's no stresses. And you're enjoying it. And that is a truly fulfilling moment when you can say, I don't want to be anywhere else. When you say, I already have everything. I'm already here. I don't want any, because you don't want anything. Your brain's not like, I need this, I want that, I want this. You're exactly where you want to be. You're exactly where you want to be. Because again, we're always thinking of things we want, but when you actually have everything you want, now people still keep going because we're kind of greedy. But if we can actually stop and appreciate that, it's a pretty great thing. So you are relaxed, you are calm, you're relaxed, you're calm, you're on the beach. Again, perfect weather, nice ocean, the waves are crashing in. No worries, you're relaxed, 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 relaxed. You are relaxed. You are exactly where you want to be. Exactly where you want to be. Exactly where you want to be. You're exactly where you want to be. You're exactly where you want to be. Your brain's not saying, well, I wish I had that, this, that, this. That part of your brain that wants things, maybe it's the ego or something. At least that's what I refer to. It's not like actually, you know, like a part of the brain, but I don't really know if that's like just like a reference, if you call it an ego. I don't actually know, but you know, the ego, I don't even know why I brought that up, but I don't know too much about that. I just know ego is kind of a bad thing. You think big of yourself, but in a bad way, like braggy. Yeah, I guess bragging, stuff like that. So anyway, that part has just stopped. You've noticed that you're just calm. You're just calm. You're not even thinking of anything. You're really just enjoying it. You're soaking up the sun. You're looking at the waves. You're saying, this is it. This is why I'm here, to just enjoy it. They're like, well, how do you do that all the time? Because that actually makes me sad. That makes me jealous. That because I want that life. But we really do have to be grateful that we have the ability to do that. We can literally, in our minds, create whatever image we want. We can go anywhere. We can do anything in our mind. And that's a cool power. Because if I said to you, would you rather have that or not? I would much rather have it because I get what you mean. If I'm thinking of myself on a super nice beach with my family, of course, I'd maybe get a little upset and say, well, I'd kind of like being there more than being in school right now. But it's an awesome ability that we can travel wherever we want. I just thought of that. It seems pretty cool, actually, that we can do that, and we are fortunate enough to do that. So appreciate that. It's a pretty cool thing. So, just travel wherever you want, okay? And you can, again, do this anytime. Just visualize yourself wherever you want to be with whomever you want. And at least for me, it does make me feel better. And if you want to ever do a relaxation thing, you can just come back on this video, listen to me talking about the beach and stuff. Share, subscribe, all that good stuff. Support is appreciated. Love you guys. And with that said, thank you so much for watching ASMR Army, and I will see you.